We all know what happened to Million Dollar Bogan, but I'm going to give you my take, and it's a little bit different than what you've been watching. First of all, my name is Gabriel Carrera, and I advertise as the attorney that rides. And I am a Harley David adventurist. And who am I to opine upon Million Dollar Bogan situation? Well, I ride Harleys, and I've ridden from the bottom of the world to the top. I've ridden the mountains of Peru, the mountains of Ecuador. I've ridden the Patagonia. I've ridden the jungles of Colombia. I've ridden the jungles of Costa Rica, all the way up through the Yukon, up the ice truckers road to Dead Horse. And I did it all on a Harley bagger. As a worldwide Harley adventurist, I identify with Bogan. Let me tell you, I identify with him, I watch his videos, and I'm not as crazy as he is, but hey, I go out there. Now, I've always caught a lot of junk from ADV riders, these KTM, BMW type guys, because, you know, they're hating on Harley, right? But here I am myself promoting Harley. I'm doing all these runs, competing with these other adventure bikes and telling them, hey, Harley Davidson can do good because, hey, they've been around forever and ever. They're built like a tank. So when I see Bogan out there doing his runs, he's riding on the beach, he's going in these mountains, he doesn't speak the language, he's trying to translate. You see him, he's bleeding. He's basically giving his life, but he's promoting Harley Davidson. You would think that Harley Davidson would give some love back to this brother, but they're not. They're not giving the love because they've changed. Back in the 60s, it was, if you didn't ride a Harley, you weren't shit. And that's the truth. That is the biker lifestyle. That is not politically correct, and if you don't like it, you can shut the button off right now. But I'm going to continue on to let you know that that's what I grew up with. In 1979, I had my first motorcycle, and I was riding, and yes, I had to hide it. It was a Suzuki, but that's all I could afford when I was 17 years old. But eventually, I got me a Shovelhead 1200, and I've had Harleys ever since, and I've been riding Harleys, and I love Harleys. But back in the day, it was basically, if you didn't ride a Harley, you ain't shit. I remember back in the early 80s when it was great to be a biker. It was a subculture. You were sort of like people like, and it was great. I wanted people to stay away from me. I didn't want to be bothered. I just wanted to hang around people that were my own kind, Harley guys. And I remember we used to get these Japanese motorcycles, and we used to take the oil out, and we'd put gas in it, and we would just tie down the throttle, let it go full blast until it exploded. Or we would hide money in it, and then we'd charge a dollar a whack to raise money for some type of charity, and people would just take the sledgehammer and whack at the motorcycle until the piece broke and you found the money, and whoever found the money, that would be theirs. And it was always about, you know, the American biker lifestyle. But I don't know, something happened in the 90s, they got watered down, and now they just want to be like everybody else. I am not like everybody else. I'm in a biker subculture, and I do videos promoting the biker subculture, and I'm not going to bow down. If Harley Davidson comes knocking on my door, they can kiss my ass. But here we got a man that is promoting Harley Davidson, a brand that morphed in the 90s to change their marketing to doctors, to lawyers, to professionals, and to get away from the scooter trash style lifestyle. Now, what I've seen Bogan do is bring professionality in that old school biker and go out there and make adventure. And hey, I've wanted to buy different Harley Davidsons, maybe get a smaller one, because I saw Bogan's to do more videos. He inspired me. But after hearing that Harley Davidson is dropping the hammer on his dealership, on his Harley dealership, dropping the hammer on him, it leaves you to wonder, why is Harley Davidson's market shares going down? Here is my rant. Harley Davidson has not been treating their base correctly. They have been bowing down to critics that don't even buy their motorcycles. In fact, I don't even think the majority of their executives actually ride. If they do, they should be showing us that. They just hired a brand new person and they got them from some type of corporation, and they don't even ride. What they need to do is come hang out with us and see what it's like, what we want to do. We are not politically correct. We are rebels. And Harley-Davidson has always been the brand of a rebel, but now they sort of taken the brand of establishment. They've watered themselves down, and now if you don't conform, they're gonna send you a cease and desist letter. They're gonna strong arm the franchise of Harley-Davidson in Australia. No, this is where I think that Harley-Davidson is going wrong, because YouTube, social media, when we make videos, they're getting free advertisement. Who the hell do they think they are to come down in a country where there's free speech and try to quash it with political correctness? And this has been going on since the early 90s. And now they're trying to change to get the millennials, to get the younger folks. What you need to do is stay true to your brand. All right, Bogan, if you're ever in South Florida, look me up. I'm gonna take you out for a steak dinner. And hey, just Google me, Attorney That Rides, South Florida, Fort Lauderdale. Kicking it hard, keeping it real. Rubber side down, shiny side up. If you like my channel and you like this type of content, please subscribe below. And not only to me, subscribe to Bogan and put a message on his site and say, don't quit. Don't let these people twist your arm. Don't let them bat you in the knees. Don't let them fall down. You don't quit. Quitters never win, and winners never quit, brother. And we get back up when we get knocked down. We get back up and we fighting, brother. Don't you quit. Don't you dare quit on me. My front tire came from underneath me. So hopefully somebody will come by. I haven't seen Kelsey for like 3 hours. I broke down on the side of the road. Front tank wouldn't go. And some guy came by from Ecuador, helped me out. Hopefully he'll come by again. He was right behind me. Stopped to have lunch. Bike is super heavy. I'm gonna try to pick it up. I don't know, we'll see what happens.